And I'll read it in the Gospel of the Word. The beginning of the Gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as it is written in Isaiah the prophet, "Behold, I send my messenger before thy face. Who shall prepare thy way? The voice of one crying in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord, make his path straight." This is the word of God, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Friday morning after Thanksgiving has often been referred to as the beginning of the Christmas shopping season. That's even been shortened recently as the beginning of the Christmas season, which we all know has been pushed way back to the beginning of October now. Even before we get finished with our preparations for Halloween, the Christmas stuff is out there, and the carols are already being pumped into our minds through the Muzak, and they're really good. You can't help singing along with them. So I don't even find it surprising that when it comes to December 21st or 22nd, we're all kind of overwhelmed and tired of it and can't quite get ready for it to all be done. That'll happen to us all. We say it's not going to happen, but it happens to us all. I can't wait for this to be over with. And then the shock of those credit card bills coming in the middle of January make it even worse. And then we're hoping we can pay those off by Easter. So we're bombarded by this consumer mentality where we've really bought into the idea that we think Christmas is all about shopping. And we all do it at some level or another. We go out and buy our presents. I think maybe somebody has gotten out of that habit, and good for you. We go shoe shopping as a family, get all of our Christmas shoes, our next shoes for the next 6 months. The three kids are always outgrowing them, and there's a really good place to buy shoes in Raleigh called SRI. I'm not getting paid any money for this commercial. They do a good job. Even a couple of years ago, I got trapped in the Black Friday thing. I was looking through the newspaper, and I saw the wall. They're going to have a really good camera on sale on Black Friday for $100. I think it was 2 or 2.5 megapixels. Most of our cameras have better megapixels. So I got up in the morning, I got in line, and I went to the Walmart. It wasn't even that bad. No one pushed me or shoved me or shot at me. I didn't get pepper spray. I didn't see anybody get arrested. There was no big fight. This is about 10 years ago that this happened. It's gotten a little bit more aggressive since then, I think. But we all fall into it. And we see it. And on Friday night, I sat down intentionally to watch the news to see what they were going to say about what happened on Friday morning. And of course, what did I see on the news? People were lined up to get into the shopping malls, and buggies full of stuff. And then there was people upset and hurt and fighting and had been pushed over and bleeding, and some people had been maced, saw them arresting somebody, had them handcuffed. I don't know what it was all about. I heard one story about someone was running through a shopping mall shooting at somebody else. I'm hoping that had nothing to do with shopping, but there were at least gunshots by. We've allowed ourselves to fall into this trap and think that Christmas is about shopping. It's about preparing for Jesus to come by buying lots of gifts for each other. And we've even allowed society to co-opt one of those good Christian words, like Black Friday. Because as a child, Black Friday happened Friday before Easter. It was very called it Good Friday at some point, because I don't have a great problem with it. But when I was a child, it was called Black Friday. You draped your cross with flag, all the churches got together. It didn't matter if you were Lutheran or Episcopalian or Methodist. One big service where I grew up, and we remembered the cross. Sometimes it's the Stations of the Cross, and sometimes it's a prayer service called Black Friday. Remembering that Jesus died for our sins on a cross as an atoning sacrifice, and all that other stuff that goes along with the cross connected to Easter. Somewhere along the way, the corporations, the Walmarts and the American Expresses and all those people decided to take that away from us, and we've allowed it to happen. For history upon history, for thousands of years, it worked the other way. The Christian church are going and put their imprint on all the pagan holidays. Christmas is one of them. There's pretty good evidence that Christmas, the baby Jesus' blood, wasn't born in the middle of December. More like born in the fall. We do Christmas because of the pagan holiday of celebrating the solstice, and we Christianized it. We said, okay, you have a good celebration, but this is a better celebration of light in the midst of darkness. The Christmas tree is another one of the pagan symbols that we took on and Christianized. Even the word Easter itself is one of the pagan gods of the bloom or blooming stuff or something like that. For years and years, we were the ones putting our imprint on what society said about stuff. But somewhere along the way, we said, it's okay for them to take our stuff away. We've abdicated our role. And we've turned the news into the news about shopping. While there's a lot of people shopping this year, wow, the consumer stuff is better. And it looks like the economy is turning around because all these people came in to buy stuff. I heard all this kind of stuff on the news, on the local news and the national news. And I seldom watch the news because it gets me really upset. And that this is one of the reasons because I'm thinking, this isn't what it's about. Then I turn to Mark's gospel and it says, this is what it's about. Mark's gospel is generally accepted to be the oldest of the gospels. It's certainly the most direct. It gets right to the point. It doesn't have this long narrative about the birth of Jesus and the nativity and the days of Caesar Augustus, etc. and so forth. I like the story, but Mark doesn't do it. It doesn't do John with his high theology, this philosophical, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Mark's gospel starts off very succinctly, very simply, and straight to the point. The beginning of the gospel, which means good news, of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Beginning of the gospel, Jesus Christ, the Son of God. This is the good news. This is the news you need to hear. Not the news that I turn on and flip the channels and stop on whatever time at 6:30 or 7 o'clock or whatever time the news comes on. That's not the news we need to hear. That's not the important news. It's not about those things that we bought or have shopped for. Advent is not a preparation for Christmas so we have all our gifts bought on time. Again, we fall into that trap over and over again. Advent is our attempt as a church to make known the Christ, the Son of God. And not just the baby Jesus in a manger, that's important, but the full-grown Jesus, the Jesus who taught us, who was an example for us, who was with us in the flesh, sharing about the kingdom of God, and not just the full-grown Jesus walking with us, but the Jesus who's on the cross, who died for us, and the Jesus who rose for us. Advent isn't just about Christmas Day. Advent is about preparing for the coming of Christ, who came in a manger and who will come again. That's what it's about. And again, because of who we are, we've allowed our holiday, holy day. That's what holiday means, holy day. You can shorten it down to holiday. Holy day. Our holy day has been co-opted by forces beyond ourselves. Anything that's not a force of the church is a pagan force. That's what it is. If you're not of the church, it's pagan. So the pagans are in control now. And we will have it to happen. And all we have to do is turn back to the scripture and see what Mark has to say about it. This is the beginning of the gospel. This is the good news. Stop paying attention to the other news and pay attention to the news that matters. Because Christmas is about this news. And preparing for this news to be in our hearts and in the world and for us to go forth and share it. What I love about Mark is it begins and ends almost the same way. In the first chapter, Mark says, I'll read it again just so we can be clear about what it says. The beginning of the gospel of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Now the last chapter of Mark is just as succinct. It begins and ends almost with the same succinct. Calling us to do something. Reminding us of what we're all about as a church. And he's writing this to the church, to the gathered people of God. To the people who believe in this resurrection. Who believe that Jesus did come. And he says this in the last verse. And they went forth, he's talking about the disciples, and they went forth and preached everywhere while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the message by the signs that attended it. And they went forth and preached it everywhere. Now again, he's talking about the disciples, but he's writing to you and to me, to the gathered people of God. This is the good news. Jesus the Christ, the Son of God. Go and preach this everywhere. We cannot allow the news that we read and see each and every day about how much money is being spent and how much things are being purchased to become the good news. Good news can't be that the economy is that much better. Good news has to be today and all day that Jesus Christ was born, that Christ is with us, and that the good news has to be so important to us that we have to be willing to go out and share it. To share that good news. To know the facts. To know how it happened. I'll say something to our Carolina football fans here. Only because you won yesterday. Because your team won. I am certain that you can tell me how many times in a row the Carolina football team has won. I know it's three. You can probably tell me the last three scores pretty clearly. You can probably tell me who was leading rushing in all those games. Who threw the most passes, who had the most sacks, and a lot of other things about each of those events. And again, I was happy to see it happen. Clemson fans, I'm sorry. It's all right. I'm sorry. It's okay. Be as excited about your faith. Be as excited about this good news as you are about that good news. Be a little bit more excited about it. Because this is eternal. This is forever. This is Christmas. Okay, you got your Christmas present a little early. But like the rest of your Christmas presents, it's fleeting, it'll go away, it'll break. Those digital cameras that I bought a few years ago, my mother-in-law never got quite comfortable with it. She still uses disposable cameras. My mother kind of uses it every once in a while, and I've had three or four digital cameras since then. This is eternal. This is forever. Like a football score, it's yesterday's news. Like a digital camera, it's yesterday's news. This is what we are all about. This is the good news. Now go and preach it everywhere. In the name of the Father, and of the Son.